Hello. Me, yes. This is a video tutorial on how to calibrate the head of a Famicom Disk System. The head, as in that thing, how to align that all good, nice, and prim and proper. Because there's a lot of people telling you different methods on it, and I mean, some they work for them, but I have found something that is de facto worko, as I would say. I've already like disassembled this unit with the screwdriver. You would need a screwdriver to do this. There's already a belt. I've taken the bottom plate off because really I just want this to be like get straight the brass tacks so you don't have to deal with like aligning it where you get your little Allen key. Yeah, you're gonna need one of these. And then you like loosen it and then you move it a little bit, then tighten it, then plug it back in, probably. And then boot it up, see if that works, and it doesn't, then turn it off, and then you try it again, again, again. None of that. So, this top is gonna have to come off, and you're gonna need to get these springs off. And there's a way to do this. I would advise lowering this, for one thing, by pulling this out. This will lower, and it'll make it easier to get these off. My lighting is somehow bad, but I think it's the camera. This is like my budget phone. This is my $25 phone. But pay attention to how the springs are aligned. Flat side here, skinny side there. There's three springs. You want to get the three springs. You want to get them good. And I'll have to like put my phone camera down to actually like take these off, but the easy part is taking them off. The hard part is putting them back on. But even then, really, it just requires like a nice pair of tweezers. I cannot emphasize how significantly helpful these things are. They'll come in like soldering,
Kits!
whatever. Let's just get on with it. I'm gonna put the phone down. I'm going to take these things off now. But yeah, just be patient and you can get it off. Yeah. Okay, now that the three springs are off, you're gonna have to lift this up at some point, and this is again gonna be a two-handed thing, unfortunately. But you want to push it up to about here, where it's in between the prongs, right? And then you're gonna want to lift this up, and you're also gonna want to clear that. But I find that like having it here is the best way of doing that. Putting it back on is a little different of a story, but yeah, just be sure that you lift this and move it out of the way. See, like that. Again, like, there might be tutorials on how to disassemble this. Apparently, this part in like particular stresses a lot of people out to the point where they don't even want to like disassemble this thing to this degree, but I personally find that this comes off easy enough. Now, for the next step, this is a later build disk system. What you're going to want to do is, yeah, there you go. Just the spring with your thumb, it'll pull this pulley system up. You see this thing? This thing, see? This one's dirty. Yeah, I know, but you want to turn the gear clockwise. There is a metal plate under the spindle wheel that will push the metal plate forward or upward. Spin the gear until the metal plate falls down and you hear a clicking sound. The click might be a little quiet, so definitely keep an ear out for it.
this one's kind of trash. Nope, there it is. Okay. So once you hear the snap and this falls back into place, you're spinning this clockwise. Remember, clockwise. Now you want to turn this counterclockwise until you can't spin it anymore. That way you'll see where the head is aligned. And holy shit, I really do have to clean this thing out, do I? I mean, I cleaned some of the grease off of the springs there. I mean, look, it's like my little Samson cartridge that I got from DK Oldies. That was refurbished, but really wasn't. Anyway, so what you want to do now that you've gotten to this point is you want to take your Allen key and you want to adjust this bolt right here, the screw, bolt, whatever. And you're actually going to want to take this off. But when you actually adjust it, I'll try to do this with one hand here. Again, I got a phone. You can't. I'm just trying to bring the content, you know? You might want to even spin it out. Like, why the hell not? Because when you take this head off, there's actually a give to where the thing was sitting back when it was factory made. There's a post behind this metal pin here that'll actually, like, seat into the Allen key here as I try and adjust it with one hand. Okay, I got it. I got it. Yeah. Okay, so now that's loose. Loosey-goosey. Just go ahead and take it off. Look at it. Savor it. Savor the flavor. I mean, even then, you can see the post that I'm talking about. Which, yeah, see? It's a little metal post in there, and that's actually a hole. What you want to do is you want to get the head of your thing, this guy, you want to get the Allen key aligned with this hole. And once you do, you progressively tighten this bolt, and you'll get to a point where it'll actually sit in there, and you could still wiggle it a little bit, but it would still stay in that pin. So I think what I'm going to go ahead and do is get this gear, and we're going to do clockwise just a little bit, because I'd like to have it sitting like right here as I tighten it. Just personal preference. Oh, it's an earthquake. There seems good. It's not perfect, but it doesn't really need to be at this step. I just know where I need the actual head to line up. But you see that hole in that post? That post in the hole? You want it to sit like right about there. Okay. Now you're going to just want to tighten this very elegantly. Like a baby. Have you ever held a baby before? Leave a like in the replies. So like, I'm getting like a little bit of resistance now. Yeah, see? So I tightened it just to the point where you can like wiggle it just a little bit, but it's not passing borders, you know. And that's because this Allen key part, this Allen key screw is, let's get some light in here. Holy shit. Yeah. There. Wow. Video became better, didn't it? This Allen key screw is now in line with the actual, like, where the alignment is, if you catch my meaning drift. Holy shit, why didn't I just think about turning on the fucking flash? So just tighten it just a little more. Little more. Little more. Alright. Now, when you tighten it, you don't want to tighten it too much. Because if you strip that little screw hole, you're fucked. Hey, how are you going to get it off at that point? But, yeah, it's pretty much calibrated at this point. I would say that this is proper calibration because, like, you know, let's follow the steps here. You had it in the hole, and you can even see, like, now the, see how it moves with it. All right, so now we got this guy all set up to the TV. That's my writer one set up there. So yeah, I got two of these. But there's two discs in particular in my collection that usually have trouble booting. And this is the whole reason I did this video, because despite all my other discs working, like, you know, the real Murasame, this is Zelda 2, but I digress. And I Senshi Nicole, which is actually a pretty cool Konami, almost like a Blaster Master kind of game. Expansion audio. Ooh. This Doki Doki Panic is corrupted, but it worked on my Sharp Twin. And I was wondering, maybe it's time passed, but after doing this calibration of this one, it started to work again. And then after doing the calibration, this one started to work again. And this one's scratched, and it's obviously scratched. But without further ado, let's just make sure that, yeah, we'll give it the hardest one first, which is this one. Flip it, disc A. Yeah. Yeah, again, it's corrupted, so. There you go, though. It does work. Not trying to jinx anything, but. And what do I mean by it's corrupted? I mean. Well, I guess I gotta flip it over to side B, and I'm too lazy to do that right now. Basically, by corrupted, I mean that it doesn't save. And I've had it like soft lock. I've had it soft lock me in certain spots. So I'm probably just going to give this a rewriting and call it a day, assuming that the disc isn't too damaged to actually do that. Now for disc 2, which is Zelda 2, which I'm going to like cut this to show like the scratch on the disc. Now hopefully this is actually catching on film. Yep, sure is. But yeah, you can see it actually has like a scuff on it. So I was thinking maybe at some point I got this damaged and that's why I wasn't reading anymore, but it just turns out that I was calibrating this shit wrong and then it got knocked out of place and now we're here. So let's just make sure that this guy works too. I'll put it in like then Might as well enjoy the opening. The reason I would want one of these working is just listen to this opening. Video's done. Thing works now. This is all extra content. Thanks for watching. I hope I helped your day. I'm getting this thing to work. The Famicom Disk System. Drop the bass now. Thank you.